Dictation start now. Honorable members, we are in the third year of the pandemic caused by coronavirus. In these areas, people of India have displayed profound faith in the democratic values, discipline and sense of responsibility. At a time when India is celebrating the Amrit Mahotsav on the occasion of 75th year of its independence, this willpower of every Indian creates immense confidence for India's bright future. With this confidence, I extend my greetings to every Indian from this historic central hall of the Parliament. Addressing both houses of Parliament assembled together today, I salute lakhs of freedom fighters who gave highest priority to their duties and secured the rights of India. I also salute all the great personalities for their contribution in the development journey of our country. In these 75 years of independence, in this period of Amrit Mahotsav, special events related to great personalities of the country are also inspiring us. My government is celebrating the sacred occasions of the 400th Prakash Parv of Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji, the 150th birth anniversary of Sri Aurobindo, and the 125th birth anniversary of Netaji Subhas Chandra Bose. From this year onwards, the government has started the Republic Day celebration from January 23rd. The fourth birth anniversary of Netaji. My government believes that remembering the past and learning from it are equally important for a secure future of the country. Observance of Veer Bal Divas on 26th December in the memory of sacrifice of and Vibhajan Vibhishika Smriti Divas on 14th August is a reflection of this thinking. The government also decided to celebrate the birth anniversary of Bhagwan Birsa Munda on 15th November as Janjatiya Gaurav Divas. As a tribute to him, Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav is a sacred occasion for all the Indians to give concrete shape to the resolutions for the next 25th years. My government is moving fast on building a strong foundation for the next 25th years, following the mantra of Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Vishwas or Sabka Prayas. The most important resolution related to this foundation is the creation of an India which includes all benefits, which is strong and self-reliant. The challenging period of Corona has inspired us to achieve our goals at the fastest possible pace for the people of our dear motherland in the shortest time as such. Honorable members, the COVID pandemic affected the entire world and in India too. Many of our loved ones were snatched away from us. In these circumstances, the central government, the state government, local governments and administration our doctors, nurses and health workers, our scientists and entrepreneurs have worked as a team. This mutual trust, coordination and cooperation between the government and citizens is an unprecedented example of the strength of our democracy. For this, I appreciate every health and frontline worker and every citizen, an example of India's capability in the fight against COVID-19 is evident in the ongoing COVID vaccination program. We have surpassed the record of administering more than 150 crore vaccine doses in less than a year. Today, we are among the leading countries in the world with the highest vaccine doses administered. Success of this campaign has given a shield to the country, providing enhanced protection to our citizens while also boosting their morale. Today, more than 90% adult citizens of the country have received the first dose of the vaccine, whereas more than 70% have been administered both the doses. The government is also reaching out to the rest of the population through the Har Ghar Dastak campaign. In the age of group 15 to 18 years have also been included in the vaccination program from this month. Precautionary dose for the frontline workers and senior citizens with comorbidities has also been started. So far, 8 vaccines have been approved for emergency use in the country. 3 vaccines being manufactured in India have also got approval from the World Health Organization of emergency use. These vaccines manufactured in India are playing an important role in making the entire world free from the pandemic and in saving crores of lives. The efforts of the country are not limited to addressing the immediate challenges. In the fight against COVID pandemic, my government is developing far-reaching solutions which would be effective and useful in future also. The launch of Pradhan Mantri Ayushman Bharat Health Infrastructure Mission with an outlay of ₹64,000 crore is a commendable example. This will not only help in meeting the current health requirements but will also prepare the country for any future crises. Health facilities are now easily accessible to the common people. Because of the responsive policies of my government, more than 80,000 health and wellness centers and crores of Ayushman Bharat cards have helped the poor immensely. In getting treatment, government has reduced the cost of treatment by providing affordable medicines through more than 8,000 Jan Aushadhi Kendra to the people in large number now.